Hello, welcome to my garage. Today we're going to make further steps on the Dolmar saw, the one from 2016. If you've seen part one, this is the one that had good compression, and at first I thought it was an easy fix, but later on I found out that the crankshaft bearing was getting stuck. So today we're going to fix that. We're going to strip the complete machine and then start rebuilding it. Don't forget to subscribe, then you can follow the whole series. And for now, enjoy this video.
And first we're going to remove all the parts. The starter goes off first, then I try to remove the electronics and the plastic covers. They all have to be done in a specific order, which I don't completely know. This bolt was stripped, that will be replaced. Now I'm trying to remove the carburetor and the part of the handle. But it's hard to see which part to take off first, and it's held in place with the springs. The bolts are quite dirty, so I have to get some dust and out before I can unscrew them. First, I have to remove the clutch. To do that, I built a special tool made from a little piece of metal with three bolts in it. The bolts has to be in exactly the right place to grip the clutch. I did this by drilling the first hole, and then the second and the third hole. I marked them with a piece of tape. Then putting in the bolts. Here I measure how deep the bolts have to go. I didn't want to put them in too far, but as far as possible. Then locking them in place with a few nuts, and then putting it on. And then putting in a rope into the cylinder to block the piston, so I can put some leverage on it without rotating it, and then it goes off quite easily. Some things are, you can see them double in the video. This was the second time I took it all apart. I found out after the first one that the crankcase bearings were damaged. When the saw was sitting for a while, it locked up. Then I've put in some oil and it came out through the side. The seals were broken, at least on one side. Here I take off the cylinder. It's held in place with four bolts, which you can reach from the bottom. The inside of the cylinder looks like new. Also, the piston and the piston ring are completely damage-free, so there's no problem. I didn't expect it to be broken because the compression of this saw was very good. Then the bolts on the side go off to split the crankcase. That's quite hard to get off, because the crankshaft will keep them together. I've tried a little bit of heat, but it didn't work really well on this part. Hitting it gently because I didn't want to damage the threads, worked the best. Here I tap it without a nut on the top, but I've checked the thread, and the thread was not damaged. There was a little bit of corrosion on the shaft, but that was easily polished away with some waterproof sanding paper with oil. Here I make a little tube to get the bearing out. But without heat, it was not getting loose. And then tapping out the seal. Heat didn't do much to it. It's not supposed to be glued in, but I hoped it would expand the aluminium a little bit. Then going on heating it up for the bearing. I didn't use the flame to prevent the paint from getting loose or burning. At about 160 degrees Celsius, the bearing came free. It's a glued-in bearing, so you need the heat to loosen the glue. The glue I used was going to about 170 degrees Celsius. Now it's hot enough. Then I put in the bolt with the large nut and it comes free. The last part, well, I was not able to get a hammer on it without damaging it. There I used the tube that goes over the bearing. Then removing the remains of the glue. Here the remains are all polished out. The new bearing goes in with some glue. So putting on some special glue, a very thin layer, there's not much room in it. Then on one side in the vise I use the two old bearings taped to each other to push it in, and the other side goes through the plastic side of the vise, the plastic protector. That worked great. Same I did with the seals, only there I used a socket that fits exactly.
That was easy.
Then putting it back together, I put on a little bit of oil just to make it slide a bit easier. The gasket that goes between the two parts is continuous, so you have to cut away the top. I assume it's to make sure that it's flush on the top. It's hard to get the two halves good to each other. When it was in a little bit, I used the screws to tighten it all up. Very carefully, of course, because it's in aluminium threads, so you can strip them quite easily. I was also making sure that it was going on quite even. It took quite a while to get it completely flush. And when it was in, I gave it a few taps, and then the seals were going, the bearings were going smooth. Throw the tubes back on. And then I've cut off the remains of the seal. So the gasket from the cylinder gets a good flat surface. and putting back on the piston. Very careful not to damage it. It's all very tight fit. On the piston there's an arrow that goes to the exhaust that was on the right side. Putting back on the cylinder, tightening up the bolts. And then putting back on the exhaust. This was a new one that came with the parts. This black cover goes on, but I have to take it off a few times more. Then putting back the clutch. And the flywheel, there's a little notch on the flywheel that has to be in exactly the right place. Then putting back in the rope, so the piston blocks, using my special tool to tighten up the clutch. Removing the rope and putting back the spark plug. Then putting back on the ignition.
Well, it's not finished yet, but we've done a lot. It was a lot more work than expected. There are a lot of parts that has to be put back together before the saw will even run. But if you make sure you subscribe, then you will definitely see the next one. And hopefully on the next one we don't get into any more problems and we can get it started. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe. See you on the next one.